also we like to know the purpose and the cause about your the conference which was there today.
SDC EC and SDC UK, which is Society of Dyers and Colorists. It's a very old society, 1884, and it's a royal charter.
Mm-hmm.
And the, Dr. Graham is the CEO of that.
Mm-hmm.
And what we do in India is conferences, various seminars, training workshop for students in color, and the young talent search, which is on textile technical students participate in this. Also the international design competition, which is globally held. So these are all the activities so far which we do in education charity. Now that we are looking at expanding horizons in India, we are looking at associating on with CSR funding in something related to color. Because we are into the system of education and we are an education charity. So the CSR activities, which will be aligning into teaching, we are trying to align with like-minded NGOs which need funds, so corporate funds. We can, you know, utilize that for training into color, giving a sustainable livelihood to these challenged people is what we are looking at, and also spreading our core value of our vision of a society of dyers and colorists, which is education of color,
yeah.
On coloration.
Yeah. I mean, our mission statement is about educating the changing world in the science of color. So it covers traditionally the sort of professional education, but certainly we have a program where we're looking at the lifelong color education pathway. And we say that's not just from school age, that's from preschool through school age, through the young children through secondary school and then into university or vocational training, on the job training. So it covers the whole range of people who are just old enough to get going and understanding colour, which everybody remembers is from a very early age, through to people who are retired and sharing their expertise and helping those. So. Historically, we have done more in the sort of working person age. Now we are looking very much at educating the changing world right across the age range, as I say, from preschool right through to retirement, and getting everyone involved in that. But the core thing is about the colour.
Good. Sanjay, do you have any special plans to raise the funding? Like you have said that you are going to a fashion show from which you're going to raise the funds. So do you have any further plans?
This is too early to comment on that, because this is the first baby step that we are taking towards, you know, aligning. First and foremost will be aligning to the education, the society's vision, as Dr. Graham has already said, is towards education of coloration. So that will be our first step. This is just what we are trying out, and there are a lot of legalities which are to be complied. The compliance, so we will take, you know, a cautious step and go.
As you will probably expect, we've been around since 1884, so we want to do something that means that we are sustainable and we carry on for even longer. So we have a lot of experience, but we want to make sure that going forward we do things that are not just a short term, but a long term. Strategic direction for us, so it's certainly something that we want to be doing in many years to come, and use the expertise and experience we have from, I think it's 134 years we've now been going.
Are you going to approach any Bollywood celebs to support the cause? Because we have seen whenever there is a charity funds or the Bollywood celeb have supported. So are you going to approach any celeb?
So far we haven't. But
we have some in the UK. We have some children's books that we produce, and we have some well-known individuals, if I call them that. Who have supported that, and we have some books who have gone to the Royal Family in the UK. We have some well-known television figures who have provided support or actually sponsored books for children in schools.
Good. Professor, do you have any special team for that, for the charity funds or some of the activities? Have you formed any special team?
We have brainstormed it. We will be, you know, because these funds are sensitive, as I said. So we need to, we will be making out a structure and we will be releasing it soon.
Okay, now finally, any message you'd like to give to the audience? Like to
have anything first and then.
I think I touched on it a little bit earlier. I mean, colour is a huge opportunity and also a huge problem for us. The opportunity is that everybody knows about colour. Even colourblind people know about colour. It's important to them. So it is everywhere and we can reach everywhere. The problem we have with that is being able to focus. And that's reflected in the comments we've made about actually not going into this sort of with a big rush, but going into this with right planning and really getting people on board so that it's not just here next year and 5 years' time, but around for many years. Whilst in the UK we've been around for over a century, the organisation in India is not new either. They've been going for many years as well.
12 years now.
It's something that we want to keep going with that. So I would say listen to the plans and get on board with those. But colour is something everybody can recognise and participate with.
Is there anything you'd like to
add? Graham has said it all. We go adding colours to people's lives and then educating right from preschool. A kid comes in, everybody knows what a colour is. If you go to any preschool curriculum, it will have first the identification of colours. So it's as basic as that. We would like to reach out to everybody on this. In the long term, maybe like in the UK, we have a colour museum where students come and walk in and use that. So maybe that would be a one step where we could have it for SDC India as well.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
So would you tell us something about the conference
you chose today? Yeah, I'm Anjali Prasad. I am the managing director of Arcroma. This was a pre-conference dinner, and in this dinner we had very good interactions about what's going to happen tomorrow in terms of the conference. And then also we unfolded the CSR activity which SDC will get into. And the CSR activity will be an important step forward for SDC, which we have not done anywhere in the world. This is the first time in India we are unfolding this activity. And there are a lot of things which can be done, and SDC, since it is more focused on coloration and teaching coloration, so we are working on the CSR activity which can lead to training of challenged people in terms of coloration. We have selected one home creation for this, where I saw they do a very good work on painting, on textiles designing in terms of coloration of textiles, wood coloration, glass coloration. So many good activities are done by these people, and this could be very interesting for even company like us, which we are also in coloration and textiles and chemistry. So this helps us to coordinate very well.
Do you have any special plan for the charity to raise the funds?
Yeah, I mean, as Acroma, we have you know, some funds which we, as a legal requirement, we have to spend for CSR fund, and one of the activities we are choosing is also this CSR activity which SDC is unfolding along with home creation. So this will be the first activity which we will try to do. I mean, mainly the other area which apart from coloration will be very important for all of us is sustainability. The ecology management, the environment, the way pollutions are done, and all these steps are very critical for even company like Arcroma, who are the leaders in textile dyes and chemicals. And our main job is to create innovation and new platforms for getting into new products which are more sustainable, less energy consumption, less water consumption, less polluting, and also you know, changing the world in terms of how the ecology can be managed, how savings can result, taking to the brands, also taking to the mills. So we are working together with most of the people. We are the biggest global company in the world now, and we have presence all over the world, wherever the textile market is there.
Thank you.
Yeah?
Any body or any
corporate sector
that
would come forward to
support? Yeah, I mean, Arkroma now, they took the first step. I've seen also MiraCamp doing that. There are also, I have got now first discussions with some of the big corporates. They're also looking at, you know, first understanding these possibilities and how we are going to spend, and based on that we can then take up these funds. But there are a lot of inquiries which will float in after this first unfolding which we have done. Because we are doing the groundwork, we are preparing ourselves how to go ahead, and once this is now done, and we can start taking the next steps. Thank you.
Om Creations Trust is a space where mentally young adults learn and get trained to work and become earning members of society. This is a space where we have a lot of areas in visual arts, where they're able to learn design and tie and dye, printing of all kinds. They also do stenciling, they do screen printing, they do ceramics in a very big way. And different types of colorings they use, from terracotta to colored ceramics. So visual arts we do in a very, we make 127 articles out of different areas of art and design. These are students with an IQ less than 50. A lot of them have an IQ less than 50, and they have multiple challenges. A lot of them cannot even speak and express themselves, but of course they express through art.
Since we have come to know that SDC has selected your NGO and to take this cause forward, how are your preparations going to be with the kids?
We are very grateful to SDC to select our project. This is we are making a residential space where the students can learn every 6 months and have a 2.5-year-old diploma and live in the same place and work in the skill development center. We use a lot of color, and when they visited our organization, they saw the walls of the NGO had frescoes. When they walked inside, they saw there was tie and dye happening. Then on the outside, they found batik was happening. Then they had a whole area of ceramics. So SDC felt that the cause was to promote color in every way, and they found that happening, so they have decided to help this cause where arts and color flourishing. So we are very grateful, because this is great help for us, and what Om Creations has tried to do by creating color and design is to go beyond the packing industry, and even the people with multiple disabilities have a lot of talent. So if STC supports us with all the paints and the dyes and the fabric, we can then concentrate and spend energies to bringing out the talent. So I'm extremely fortunate that they have looked at our cause and they want to help us. So we will now, I guess, be partners with them.
On an initial level, as the cause proceeds, how many students would be, how many number of students would be there on the initial stage?
So the whole finished project is for 360 students. We are beginning with 80 students.
And this would be limited to Mumbai only or across India?
No, this is actually in Karjat. We also are going to be working with economically poor children and tribal children. We also are looking at using this model to then work with different states of the country. But this is the pioneering pilot project in this area with a residential facility.
Any difficulties you face, certainly requires special training for the students. Any difficulties you still coming across and you want to overcome?
Yes, in the area of mental challenges, have a lot of struggles. Because when a student has a less IQ, also his expressions are not very easy to understand. So we need to first engage ourselves in educating ourselves as trainers. How can we understand their wealth and how can we guide them? And not just because what I know that I should make them do, but what they do well, I should make them do that. So the challenge is how to understand them and then bring out their potentials. So for that, you need to increase your knowledge, do a lot more thinking, and find out what is good for that person. And then they surpass all the challenges of their disability because they want to do it. So the challenge is to understand them and to bring out their potential.
Recently, we have seen there has been many corporate companies who have come up who have supported this kind of students and kids and inputs on
it. Yes, with the 2% CSR, it has been very helpful. The companies are looking forward to help you. And what I experienced, because I've been in the field for 32 years, that when it's a business house, they look at this also in a way, in a project that they want to complete well. You know, so the grant is very different from a grant coming from a government, because here there is the work culture and the ethic ki kuch achha kare, kuch society mein usko aur badhaye aage. So there is that passion in a lot of companies, and the way SDC has come up, you can actually see the ethical and the passionate part of it being balanced. So it's been a great help to have this 2% CSR. It has made us NGOs also a better person, because we've also learned a little bit of the corporate culture, and we are also getting more professional.
Thank you.
We'd like to thank SDC.